Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. So on today's video, we're gonna go over a new tool that I got for the Lexus and Toyota vehicles. This is a diagnostic tool that I got that plugs up to your OBD2 port, and it gets you a lot of the features that you find on Techstream and other OEM software that you can use on these cars. So we'll go over a review of this today, so stay tuned. So before we get started today, I want to go over the winners of my contest that I did a couple weeks ago when I did my differential install on my Lexus IS250. If you didn't watch that video, all I asked for at the end of that video is anybody that was watching it, just leave a comment on that video for a chance to win a care package from Super Clean. If you don't know what Super Clean is, they're a degreaser brand that sends us products to use on this channel. And I've used their products for over 4 years now, and I really love this stuff. It's very potent, it works really well, it cleans all my cars. If you've seen any of my videos, you'll see that I keep everything on my cars clean, in the garage clean, and with the help of Super Clean, that makes it really easy. So for that video, I chose two winners to receive a care package straight from Super Clean. Guy990, you're the first winner of that contest. I'll go ahead and reach out to you to send me your contact information on Instagram. If you're watching this video before you get my comment, go ahead and send me your information. The second winner is Dewan Rue. You're another one of my subscribers that watches a lot of my videos and leaves a lot of comments, so I want to reward you with a care package from Super Clean. So for today's review video, we're gonna go over this Launch OBD2 scanner right here. So this is not your generic normal OBD2 scanner, even though it does have those functions. What this thing does come with is specialty software for whatever car you have. For this particular unit I've got and I'm gonna review, it's for Toyota and Lexus vehicles. So it comes preloaded with all the software you need to scan and do diagnostics for your Toyota or Lexus vehicles, all the way up to the current model. So this unit is about $140 on Amazon. If you need a link to the exact same unit, check out the links down in the description of this video to go to Amazon to check this thing out. So as far as what comes in this box, so you get the scanner right here, and it comes with a pre-molded and attached OBD2 plug. It also comes with a USB cord right here to plug up while you're using it off the car. And it comes with your quick start and your instruction manuals. Everything else is pretty much digital and online, and you can look it up to use it. The thing with this thing is it doesn't have a battery or any kind of power source. So if you use it outside of the vehicle, you have to actually plug up the USB-C cable. When you're in the car, you plug it up to the port and it's powered by the 12 volts from your car. So you don't have to worry about any kind of batteries or anything once you plug it up to the car. As far as the reason why I'm testing and using this thing is, if you guys didn't know, Toyota Techstream is an OEM software. And recently, the end of 2023, they actually quit supporting regular Techstream, and they've released a new version called GTS Plus, which is Global Techstream Plus. And that's more of a live subscription where you actually have to have a login and a current subscription to use. On the old Techstream, you could kind of sideload that and get it nefarious ways by going online and figuring that out. They no longer have that version available, so it's gonna be much harder to diagnose newer vehicles. So something like this will help you diagnose newer vehicles. So as far as setting this up, when you first initially get it open, you actually have to select the country you're in and then connect to a Wi-Fi so it can download the latest updates and all the data and live information that you might need for your vehicle. Once it's all updated and ready to go, you go ahead and just plug it up to your car, let it detect the car that's in. If you're in North America like myself, I think you need a select 16-pin OBD2 port. And after that, it should figure out what car you're plugged up to, and you just need to confirm it and go through all the menus. Once it connects to your vehicle, you'll notice that it has all the various ECUs, ECTs, or ECMs, the different computers all through the car. You could select health scan, and it'll scan all of those actual computers on your car and give you all the history and the codes stored to that. This is pretty much the same exact menu that Techstream uses, and you can see the side-by-side right here, what we see in Techstream versus what you see on the actual screen itself here. As I was playing with the menus throughout this scanner and everything, everything on here reminds me of using Techstream. You could go through all the options, like the specialty features for each of your vehicles. You could select options like lighting options, time delays, lock options, seatbelt options. You can actually go in there, program your key remote as far as the actual key, like pressing the key. On later videos, I'll go ahead and test this thing out on my Lexus IS250, on my Sienna, and on my Avalon, just to see the different menus there and compare those against Techstream. But as far as me playing around with this on the IS300, a lot of the menus on here are exactly what I see in Techstream when I'm playing with Techstream, along with the different diagnostics and everything. You can watch real-time data, you can see all the positions of your different systems. You can actually go in there, hook up to your HVAC, hook up to your gauge cluster, and actually move and mess with the needles just to make sure everything's working properly. You can engage your HVAC through this to see how everything's working. You can do a lot of things in software, which makes diagnostics really great on this to test things out that you need to test with on the car. As you can see on this scanner right now, it's got 17 pin standards. I'm not sure where that's used, but that's an option on here also. In addition to reading just the Toyota stuff, this thing also has a generic OBD2 scanner. You know, scan all the different OBD2 protocols depending on the vehicle or what you plug it up to. You won't get all the custom stuff for the Toyota like you do on this version of it, but you'll get the generic codes and check engine lights that you'll get on various other vehicles through the OBD2 standard. So as you can see, I've got Techstream open and you can see me clicking through, connecting to the actual IS300. This is the same way you would do it on the launch scanner. It goes through, you pick your car and then you just go next. Remember, on the next scanner, you have to select the 16 pin North America or Europe standard. Once we're inside the menu, you'll see that we get to the health check. And on Techstream, you can hit health check and it opens this menu that selects all the ECUs or selectively set the ECUs you want. And in there, you could do the same with the launch tool too. Once you get in there, you could hit the health check and it'll scan all your ECUs and get you all the different error codes or stored data that it has on there. So once we get the health report, you could clear all the codes out and see if they come back by hitting the clear DTC button, and it'll clear everything in that ECU. As you can see, we're going into the immobilizer menu in Techstream, and it's gonna pull up all the different options you could do with an immobilizer. And over in the launch tool, you can see the exact same menus. You can program the keys, you can program new immobilizers or new remotes through this handheld launch tool also. So next on Techstream, you can see we go into the customize menu, and that's gonna bring up this menu over here that pretty much mirrors what we can pull on the launch tool also. And these are all the same menus that it's reading. As you can see in Techstream, when you go program the new transponder, you could choose a master key or another secondary key along with other options there. This is for the immobilizer menu. If you want to do wireless remote, there's actually another ECU on the body that you have to select to do that one. But again, all these same options can be found in that new launch tool also. So you can see we're here in the HVAC menu, and as I explained earlier in the video, you go in here, look at all the various settings, readings off your HVAC system. You actually test and control some of this stuff, like turning on your compressor, turning on your blowers, moving your servo and everything through the various menus in this launch tool. But it's a very good tool if you're just trying to troubleshoot things and see if things are actually reacting and you actually hear stuff moving by commanding it. One of the downsides of this tool, as well as Techstream, is just that the CAN bus or the OBD2 system that I have on here is just very slow. It's all serial communication, so you kind of gotta wait for a lot of these menus to go from like 10% to 100%. Sometimes it takes a couple minutes just to do this. So now that we've gone through all the comparisons of Techstream and some examples of Techstream versus the launch tool on the IS300, I'll just show you a generic demo of going through the different menus and how it scans and the kind of information it provides through these screenshots right here. Depending on the error or the OBD2 code, you actually click on it and it'll take you to the web or to other resources to give you a better explanation of what the code means or what the issue is. So as you can see, going through this quick review of this thing, this tool is actually really good and really has a lot of features that you're gonna find in more OEM tools. And for the price of $140 without dealing with different bootleg softwares and hacking stuff online, this is a great tool for most of you to have. especially on your newer vehicles where you can actually program your smart keys, program your tire monitoring system sensors, and other diagnostic features that is really hard to do with other OBD2 scanners. If you guys need the same product, just check out the links down in the description to order your own if you want to do the diagnostics yourself. I want to thank you guys for watching all the way to the end of this video. If you found this video useful, give it a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, go ahead and subscribe to the channel so I can go ahead and update you on future videos on this scanner where I'm testing it on the other cars. Remember guys, for all these different projects, if I can do it, you guys can do it. I want to thank you for watching and I'll talk to you guys next time.